I learn in this letter that Don Pedro of Aragon comes this night to Messina, and that he hath bestowed much honour on a young Florentine called Claudio.
Much deserved on his part, for he hath borne himself beyond the promise of his age, doing the feats of a lion.
I pray you, has Signor Montanto returned from the wars yet or no?
I know none of that name, lady.
My cousin means Signor Benedick of Padua.
Oh, he's returned, and as pleasant as ever he was, and a good soldier too.
He's no less than a stuffed man.
You must not, sir, mistake my niece. There is a merry war betwixt Signor Benedick and her. They never meet, but there's a skirmish of wit between them.
Don Pedro approaches. Good Signora Leonato, I think this your daughter?
Her father hath many times told me so.
Are you sure that you aren't? If Signora Leonato be her mother, she would not have her head on her shoulders for all Messina, as like her as she is.
I wonder that you will still be talking, Signor Benedick. Nobody marks you.
What, my dear Lady Disdain? Are you yet living?
Is it possible Disdain should die while she has such meat food to feed it as Signor Benedick?
It is certain I am loved by all ladies. Only you accepted. But truly, I love none.
A dear happiness to women. I'd rather hear my dog bark to crow than hear a man swear he loves me.
Well, you are the rare parrot, teacher.
A bird of my tongue is better than the beast of yours.
I wouldn't my horse have the speed of your tongue.
Right! Signor Claudio and Signor Benedict, Leonato have invited you all.
Let me bid you welcome, my lord. Being reconciled to the prince, your brother, I owe you all duty.
I thank you. I'm not a man of many words, but I thank you.
Benedict, didst thou know the daughter of Signora Leonato? In mine eyes, she's the sweetest lady that ever I looked on.
I can yet see without glasses, and I see no such matter. You have no intention to turn husband.
Husband? What secret have you held till you follow not to Leonato's?
He's in love. With whom? Mark how sure his answer is. With Hero.
God forbid it should be otherwise.
Amen if you love her, for the lady is worthy.
That I love her, I feel.
And that she is worthy, I know.
I can never see how she should be worthy or how she should be loved. It's the fire you cannot melt out of me. I would die if it stayed.
Ere I shall see thee die pale with love.
With anger, with hunger, or with sickness, not with love, my lord.
In good time, the savage bull doth have the oak. In the meantime, prepare to Leonato's. Tell her I will not fail her at supper. If thou dost love fair Hero, cherish it, and I will break with her and her mother, and thou shalt have her.
How sweetly you do minister to love.
Let us put it in practice presently.
What the good year?
My lord,
why art thou out of measure sad?
I cannot hide what I am. I must be sad when I have cause, and smile at no man's jests.
Yea, but you must not make the full show of this. You have inflicted out against your brother, and he hath newly taken you into his grips.
I am a plain dealing villain. Therefore, I shall not decrease to sing in my cage. If I had my mouth, I would bite. In the meantime, however, seek not to alter me.
I can give you intelligence of an intended marriage.
Intended marriage? Will it serve to a mischief on?
Marry it is, your brother's right hand.
The most exquisite Claudio. And who? And who? Which way looks he?
Marion Hero, the daughter and heir of Leonato.
Claudio, that young startup hath all the glory of my overthrow.
If I can cross him in any way, I bless myself in every way.
You will assist me
to the death world.
Lady, will you walk about with your friend?
So you walk softly and look sweetly. I'm yours for the walk.
And you won't tell me who you are?
No, you shall pardon me.
And you won't tell me who told you so either?
Not now.
They said that I was disdainful, and that I had my wit out of 100 merry tales. Was this Signor Benedick that said so?
Who's he?
Why, he's the prince's jester, a very dull fool. His only talent is devising impossible slanders.
Well, I know the gentleman. I'll tell him what you say.
Do, do.
Will your grace command me any service to the world's end? I'll go on the slightest errand. Fetch you a toothpick, from the furthest inch of Asia. Bet you a hair of the great charms be your ambassador to the pigmies. Rather than hold conference with this harpy, have you no employment for me?
None, but for your good company.
My lord, this is a dish I love not. I cannot endure my lady's tongue.
Come, lady, come, for you have lost the heart of Signor Benedick. Claudio! I have wounded thy name, and fair hero is won. I broke with her, and her goodwill obtained. Name the day of marriage, and God give thee joy.
Count, take of me my daughter, and with her my fortunes.
Speak, Count, 'tis your cue.
Silence is the perfectest herald of joy.
Good lord, for alliance. Everyone is going, but I may sit in the corner and cry hey-ho for our husband.
Will you have me, lady?
No, my lord. Unless I have another for working days. Your grace is too costly to wear every day. But I beseech you pardon me. I was born to speak all mirth and no matter.
To be merry best becomes you.
Niece, will you look to those things I told you of?
I cry you mercy, aunt. The good lord pardoned me.
By my troth, a pleasant-spirited young lady.
There's a melancholy element in her, my lord.
She cannot endure to hear tell of a husband.
True, true. She mocks all her woes out of suit.
An excellent suitor for Benedick.
Oh, lord. My lord, if they were but a week married, they would talk themselves mad.
Come, Claudio, for the time will not go dully until we marry. In the meantime, I must endure one of Hercules' labours to bring Signor Benedict and Lady Beatrice in a mountain of affection with one another. Come, and I will tell you my drift.
It is so that Count Claudio shall marry the daughter of Leonato.
Yea, but I can cross it.
How canst thou cross this marriage?
Not honestly, my lord.
Show me how.
I think I told your lordship how much I'm in favour of Margaret, the waiting gentlewoman's hero.
I remember.
I can, at any unseasonable instant of the night, appoint her to look out of her chamber window.
What life is that to be the death of this marriage?
Draw Don Pedro and Count Claudio alone. Tell them you know hero loves me. Offer them instances to see me at her chamber window. Hear me call Margaret hero. And bring them here to see this the very night before the intended wedding.
Be cunning in the work of this. And thy fee is 1,000 ducats.
Action.
I do much wonder that one man, seeing how much another man is a fool to dedicate his behaviours to love, will become an object of his own scorn by falling in love. Such man is Claudio. Will I be converted and see with these eyes? I think not. The prince, Monsieur Love, I will hide him.
See you where Benedict had hid himself?
Very well, my lord.
Come hither, Leonato. What was it you told me of today? That your niece Beatrice is in love with Signor Benedict.
Oh, aye. Stockholm, the foul sins. I would have never thought she would have loved any man.
No, nor I neither. But so wonderful that she so doted on Signor Benedict, whom she hath in all outward behaviour seemed ever to abhor.
Is it possible? Sits in the wind in that corner.
By my troth, my lord, I cannot tell what to think of it, but that she loves him with enraged affection.
Well, I would think this is a hoax. But Leonato speaks it.
He hath taken the infection. Hold it up.
Hath she made her affection known to Benedick?
No, and she swears she never will. That's her torment.
Down upon her knees, she falls, cries, weeps, beats her heart, tears her hair, prays, curses. Oh, sweet Benedick, God, give me patience.
She doth indeed. My daughter says so.
It were good if Benedick knew of this.
To what end? He would make but a sport of it, and torment the poor lady worse.
She is an excellent lady, and despite all suspicion, very virtuous.
And she is exceeding wise.
Exceeding wise in all, but loving Benedick.
For hero thinks surely she will die. For she says she will die, if he love her not. And she will die, if he woo her, rather than she bade one breath of her accustomed crossness.
We will hear further this from your daughter. In the meantime, let it call.
My lord, will you walk? Dinner is ready.
If he do not dote upon her, I shall never trust my expectations.
The same net must be spread for her by your daughter and the gentle carrywoman. We'll send her to fetch him for dinner.
This could be no trick. Love me. Why? This must be requited. They say she's fair. 'Tis the truth. And virtuous. 'Tis so. And wise. But for loving me, oh, for horribly in love with her. Here comes Beatrice. I do spark some marks of love in her.
Against my will, I'm sent to bid you to come in to dinner.
I thank you, Beatrice, for your pains.
It took no more pains for your thanks than it took for you to thank me. If it had been painful, I wouldn't have come.
So you take pleasure in the message?
Yea. Just as much as you might take pleasure in being held at knife point. Fare you well, Signor.
Against my will, I've been sent to bid you to come in for dinner. There's a double meaning in that. I do not take pity. I'm a villain. If I do not love her, well then, I'm a fool.
Good Margaret, run me to the parlour. There shalt thou find my cousin Beatrice. Whisper her ear and tell her that I and Ursula walk in the orchard, and our whole discourse is all of her.
I'll make her come, I warrant you.
Now Ursula, when Beatrice doth come, my talk to thee must be how Benedick is sick enough of Beatrice. Now begin, for look where Beatrice like a lapwing runs close by the ground to hear our confidence. No, truly, Ursula, she cannot love, she's too self-endeared.
But are you sure that Benedick loved Beatrice so entirely?
So says the prince and my new trusted lord.
And did they bid you tell her of it, madam?
They did entreat me to acquaint her of it, but I persuaded them, if they love Benedick, to let him wrestle with affection, and to never let Beatrice know of it.
Did you so? Doth not the gentleman deserve a full bed that Beatrice shall have a couch upon?
Oh, God of love, I know he doth deserve as much as may be yielded to a man, but nature never framed a woman's head of prouder stuff than that of Beatrice, disdain and scorn lies sparkling in her eyes. She cannot love, she's too self-endeared.
Certainly, and therefore she'll make a sport at it.
Why, you speak truth. Therefore, let Benedick, like covered fire, consume away in sighs, waste inwardly. It were better death than to die of mocks, which is as bad as die of tickling.
We have caught her, madam.
If prove so, loving goeth by haps. Some cupids kill with arrows, some with traps.
What fire is in mine eyes? Can this be true? Stand I be condemned for pride and scorn so much? Contempt farewell, and maiden pride adieu. No glory is behind the back of such. And Benedick, love on. I will requite thee, taming my wild heart to thy loving hand. For others say thou dost deserve, and I believe better than reporting thee.
Gallants, for I am not as I have been.
So says I, methinks you sadder.
I hope you be in love.
There is no true drop of blood within him that wants love. If he's sad, he wants money.
If he be not in love with some woman, there is no believing in old signs. He brushes his hat every morning. What must that bode?
And rubs with civet. Can you not smell him off by that?
That's as much as to say that the sweet youth's in love.
Signora Leonato, walk with me, but I have advised 8 or 9 wise words to speak to you that these hobby horses cannot hear.
My lordship and brother, God save you. Means your lordship to be married tomorrow?
If there is any impediment, I pray you discover it.
I came hither to tell you the lady is disloyal.
Disloyal?
The word is too good to paint out her wickedness. Come with me tonight, and you see her chamber window entered. Even the night before her wedding day,
If you love her, then tomorrow wed her. But it would better fit your honour if you change your mind.
May this be so?
I will not think of it.
If I see her tonight, doing anything, I will not wed her tomorrow. In fact, I shall shame her.
And I will be with thee to disgrace her.
I will disparage you no further until you are my witness.
You. I thought you to be the most senseless and fit man for the constable of the watch. Therefore, bear you the land. This is your charge. You shall comprehend all vagrant men and bid them stand in the prince's name.
But how if you will not stand?
Well, why then, thank God you're rid of knave. Well, masters, good night. If there be any match of weight changes, call up me.
Well, masters, we hear our charge. Let us sit upon the watch bench till two. And then we shall go to bed.
One word more. I pray you watch about Signora Leonata's door. For the wedding, be there tomorrow. There shall be a great coil tonight. Adieu. Be vigilant. I beseech you.
What? Peace, stir not.
Comrade, I say. Here, man, I'm at
thy elbow. Fool with thy tail.
Stand thee close under this penthouse, for it chisels with bone. And I, like a true gentleman, will utter all to thee.
Some treason, master.
Therefore know, I have earned of Don John 1,000 ducats, and I've tonight wooed Margaret by the name of Hero. The prince, Claudio, and my master, planted by my master, Don John, saw this amiable encounter.
They thought Margaret was Hero.
Turkey did, the prince and Claudio, but my devil master knew she was Margaret. Away went Claudio in rage, swore he would meet her as he was appointed next morning at the temple, and there before the whole congregation shame her with what he saw overnight and send her home again without a husband.
We charge you in the name of the law, in the name of the prince. Well, constable, call the constable.
Masters,
never speak. We charge you. Let us obey. You go with us.
What with me, honest neighbour?
Well, one word, signora. Our watch, signora, have comprehended two auspicious persons, and we would have them examined before your worship.
Take the examination yourself and bring it me. I am now in great haste. Fare you well.
Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel.
Be brief, only to the plainest form of marriage.
You come hither, my lord, to be married to this lady. No.
To be married to her? Friar, you come to marry her.
My lady, you come hither to be married to this count.
I did.
If either of you know of anything within the enemy, why you should not be conjoined? I charge you on your souls. Utter it. Know you any hero?
None, my lord.
Know you any count?
I do. She is but the sign and semblance of her honour. She knows the heat of a luxurious bed.
What do you mean, my lord?
Not to be married, not to knit my soul to an approved wanton.
It's my lord Bart that you don't speak so wide.
Sweet prince, why you speak not?
What should I speak? I stand dishonoured. I've linked my dear friend to a common stale.
Please, you've spoken of my but dream.
Who was it you talked with yesternight, out at your window betwixt 12 and 1?
I talked with no man at that hour, my lord.
Leonato, I am sorry you must hear, upon my honour, that myself, my brother, and this grieved count saw her, heard her at the late hours of the night with a ruffian.
Fair, Leonato, most foul, most fair. Fare thee well, for I shall lock up all the gates of love.
Come, let us go. Smother her spirits up.
How doth the lady?
Dead, I think. Aunt, Signor, Friar.
O fate, take not away thy heavy hand. Death is the fairest cover for her shame. That may be wished for.
My soul, my cousin is belied. How now, cousin Hero?
Have comfort, lady.
Do not live, Hero. Do not open thine eyes.
Hear me, Alessio. Call me a fool. Trust not my age, my calling, nor reverence and divinity. If this sweet lady lie not helpless here, under some biting error, lady, what man is he you are accused of?
They know that do accuse me. I know none.
There is some strange misprison in the princes.
The two of them be very bent of honour. Their wisdom's misled. It's the practice that lives in John the Bastard.
If they wrong her honour, the proudest of them shall well hear of it.
Pause a while. Let my counsel sway you in this case. Publish it that she's dead indeed.
What will this do?
She died upon the very instant she was accused. She'll be lamented, pitied, and excused of every hero. So would it fare with Claudio. Then shall we mourn. Ever love had interest, and he shall wish he had not so said those things.
Senor, the friar advise you.
Being that I flow in grief, the smallest twine may lead me.
It is well consented. Come, lady, die to live. This wedding day is perhaps prolonged. Have patience and endure.
Did mean upon his words to disgrace Hero before the whole assembly and not to marry him.
Oh, villain.
What else? This is all.
This is more masters than you can deny. Prince John this morning secretly stolen away. Hero was in this manner accused, in this manner refused, and upon the grief of this suddenly died. Master Constable, let these men be bound and brought to Leonato's.
See, see! Here is the man we went to seek.
Now, Signor, what news? What thinkst thou?
My thoughts. Shall I draw?
God bless me with a challenge.
You are a villain. You jest not. I will make it good. What you dare, when you dare, and will you dare. My lord, I thank you for your many courtesies, but I must discontinue your company. Your bastard brother has fled from Messina. And you and Mong have killed an innocent lady. Lord Blackbeard and I will meet. But until then, peace be with him.
He is in earnest.
In much profound earnest.
Did he not say my brother was fled?
Leonato one. Officer, what offence has this man done?
Sweet prince, let this count kill me. The lady is dead upon mine and my master's false accusations, and I desire nothing but the reward of a villain.
Yes.
Sorry.
Your speech runs through your blood like iron.
I have drunken poison whilst he uttered it. Sweet hero.
Art thou the slave that killed my innocent child?
Yea, even I alone.
No, not so, villain. Here stand a pair of honourable men. A third has fled that had a hand in it. I thank you for my daughter's death. Record it with your high and worthy deeds. 'Twas bravely done.
Choose your revenge upon me, for I have sinned. Though I have not sinned, but been mistaken.
I cannot bid you bid my daughter live. That was impossible. But I pray you both, possess the people of Messina here, how innocent she died. Tomorrow come you to my house. My sister hath a daughter, almost a copy of my child that's dead. Give her the right you should have given her cousin, and so dies my revenge.
We will not fail.
Bring you these fellows on. Tomorrow we shall talk with Margaret about how her acquaintance grew with this lewd fellow.
Didn't I tell you she was innocent?
So are the prince and Claudio, who'd accuse her upon the error that you had debated.
Well, I'm glad that all things sort so well.
And me too. I would have been enforced to bring young Claudio to the reckoning for it.
Daughter and gentlewomen of, withdraw into your chamber yourselves, and when I ask you, come hither. You know your office, sir. You must be mother to your sister's daughter, and give her to young Claudio.
Friar, I must entreat your parents.
To do what, signor?
To bind me or undo me. Signor Leonato, my good signora, your niece requires you with an eye of love, and I do, with an eye of favour, requite her.
But what is your will?
My will is your good will. Join us, as we'll get married in the honourable state of marriage. Good signora.
My heart is with your liking.
And so my help. Here come Claudio and the prince.
Good morrow to this fair assembly.
Good morrow, prince. Good morrow, Claudio. We here attend you. Are you yet determined to marry my sister's daughter?
I'll hold my mind. Which is the lady that I must seize upon?
The same as she, and I do give you her.
Why then? Sweet, let me see your face.
No, and you shall not until you take her hand before this friar and swear to marry her.
I am your husband, if you like of me.
And when I lived, I was your other wife. And when you loved, you were my other husband.
Another hero.
Nothing certain of. One hero died to fire, but I do live. And surely, as I'm living, I am remained. The former hero. The hero that is dead.
She died, my lord. But whilst her slander lived,
all this amazement I can qualify when after that the holy rites ended. I'll tell you largely of fair hero's death. And to the chapel presently. Sweet and fair, friar. Which is Beatrice?
I answer that name. And what is your will?
Do you not love me?
Why not? No more than reason.
Or your aunt, Claudio, and the prince, they must have been deceived, for they swear you did.
And do you not love me?
No. No more than reason.
Why? But my cousin, Margaret, and Alice were deceived. Because they swear you do.
They swore you were almost sick for me.
They swore you were well nigh dead for me.
And I swear upon that he loves her, for in his hand is a note fashioned for Beatrice.
And another, stolen from my pocket, written in my cousin's hand, containing her affection unto Benedick.
A miracle, our hand against our heart. Come, I will have these, but in this light I take thee for pity.
And I would not deny you, but by this good day I am swayed by great persuasion. And partly to save thy life, for I was held during consumption.
Peace.
How does this marriage, Benedick?
As I do much purpose to marry, I will think nothing that the world can say against it. And on that part, Claudio, I would have beaten thee. And so, as my kinsman, live unbruised and love my cousin.
I would have hoped that you would have denied Beatrice, in that thee would have cudgelled thee out of thy single life.
Come, we are friends. Let us dance as we are married. Let us lighten our hearts and our wives' heels. The prince said, get me a wife, get me a wife. Think not on him till tomorrow. I will devise my brave punishment for him. And so, strike up the pipers!